This is NerdFT Radio, where nerds full-time, explorers of the metaverse, surfers of the blockchain, and not in our mom's basement. I'm your host, RSG, a.k.a. the Orange Line King, and I'm here with Crypto Crier, a.k.a. the Doodles Maxi. Crier, we are so fucking back. How are you?
Doing good, man.
Can you confirm that? That is not a fib by me?
Yeah, it is confirmed. I am now back on the peace train.
He is back. We're actually both back. We were fortunate enough to be able to go over to Chicago, the land of, and witness and experience Doodles and Camp's partnership at the Camp Store. Obviously, that's going to be the big topic of today's episode, talking about our trip over to Chicago. Fortunately, on my end, was able to go to the event, and thankfully on the Crier end, and also Crier's whole family, was able to not only go to the main event, but also the community-led events, which we'll talk a little bit about as well. Besides that, we'll talk a little bit about brand growth in the space. That's one of the topics, I think, from the last episode I had with the rant, and so many people just so negative about these projects. But we've seen so much growth from Pudgy to Cool Cats to what we just witnessed, Doodles, and all these other projects and what they're doing. So we'll talk a little bit about that and also compare them to other brands that we all love and care for as well. And of course, we're going to nerd it out at the end of today. So let's go into the number one topic that we have today, which is Doodles and Camp. Crier, on a scale of 1 to 10, how was your trip to Chicago?
Chicago is awesome. I had a great time. I think the
way better than New York, right?
Yeah, it was 100 times better than New
York. 10 times. Thank you. All right. By the way, Yankees suck. Keep going.
Yeah. Huge. Yes. Just the city was awesome. I hadn't been in a really long time, so I got to take the whole family. Definitely the experience was extremely good. I was overly impressed with what I was executed there, especially for the length of how long it's going to be there. It's got 6 months. And I went back on the opening day where it was just like people that aren't in the community at all. I have literally regular no idea people. What any of this is. And they're taking their kids to just like a little thing to do, get out of the house. And it's $30 and it's not that, but it's not very expensive. And so many kids were like extremely excited about it. I thought it was, my kids absolutely loved it. And just for the experience, you really do get like almost like a picture if they took one of the experience rides from Universal Studios and made it into a thing. That's how I'm picturing it, right? Like you have this like little escape that you can do with your family. You don't have to spend an insane amount of money, right? If you go to a theme park, it's going to be crazy expensive. And it's not all day long either. So it's like a fun thing to get out and do. A
couple hours.
Yeah. Just what happened there was essentially you were given a bracelet. And the bracelet had a little RFID chip. You would go around the room like a scavenger hunt and collect Doodles wearables off the wall, right? Or off random places in the entire place. So the kids were running around finding stuff, slides and ball pits and interactive things. And they were able to dress up their Doodle and do crafts. And there were all actors there to help them do crafts and help them do things. And it was definitely a really good experience on that side. And it gets you in as the parent as well. Like certain things to find with your kid are difficult to find. You have to lift your kids up and find them. There's definitely a lot of interaction on that side. And it was fun for adults too. There was like little games and it wasn't like it was just like, oh, only my kid would like this. I definitely think it's much more geared towards family, obviously, but I know it's a great market to go after. That's what Pudgy's going after with kids' toys. I think that's a big kid toy brands are some of the largest IP brands in existence. I do think that's the good move. All of the merchandise look great. And it wasn't like crazy overpriced now. $30 for a shirt. Playing cards look good. But those were like 10 or 15. I don't think they were very expensive.
$12. Go on Camp, their website, and you can get 10% off.
20% off.
20% off any purchase in store or online. Camp. But, shot or hit us up.
Yeah, this guy. Free ads for RSG there. But the idea was merchandise wasn't that expensive. My daughter got the cat. She was like, oh, I want the cat. Because she she experienced this and it's like a little interactive thing. You meet the characters and then at the end you're like, oh, the cat does a bunch of cute funny things. And it's a little toy that's like $30. for our stuffed animal, and she's been carrying around since we got it.
Every single day.
Yeah, so I just think the connection there from the pudgy side, she doesn't have that at all. She's, oh, these are cool, and then doesn't play with it anymore. But with the cat, I feel like it's even more of a connection because she got to experience a thing that she really enjoyed, and we were talking about Hayes is going crazy about it. And now she's, oh, the cat. She's, I'm going to introduce my cat to all my babies because she's like a huge, yeah, what's this cat?
Yo, if your daughter needs to have a little pitch on a little Mr. Hey, Cool got, Cat,
she's got
Blue.
Jugs. She's got Jugs. Ooh, okay. Here, so.
Damn it. All right, keep going. Sorry. I tried, guys.
But I'm saying, though, like it's the experience portion is absolutely what connects people to the IP. It doesn't, like you getting a random penguin, you're like, oh, these are cool. They're cute. It's a penguin as a kid. Whereas this is like, oh, I went to this really cool event and I went to Doodle World and then I got Mello the cat. That's what she's kind of stuff saying like that. So I do think they executed that crazy, and for what it is, I think they did a crazy good job. You know, very impressed with what everything they executed there. If anything, they do live events well, and now they've monetized it.
100%. And what I also experienced there, again, I would definitely agree with you. It's obviously more on the kids' side. A lot of my comparison to what I experienced was, like you said, interactive ride at Universal Studios or Disney. More on the lines of what Disney's been doing for the past few years is not only are they making great rides, but they're actually making the line part, like the experience of being in line, more interactive, like, yeah, using an app, doing more stuff so that you're not just bored sitting there two freaking
hours.
Men
in Black ride or whatever. You're like,
yeah, you're doing, there's more stuff. There's more stuff to do. And also on the flip side, now there's an app at Disney where you just download it and every single line has its own game, which is a lot. It's better for people just sitting there. Obviously other people of our age or even teenage and above, they're just on their cell phone on X or on Instagram or whatever, on a game, Marvel Snap, by the way. But how I compared it, and this is the one bad thing I had, which obviously later down the road it could change. I felt like for me personally as an adult, it was like the Disney line, and unfortunately there wasn't like the ride at the end. I know you experienced Cooltopia with myself in New York, yeah, where it was similar to the same thing. It was the whole experience, but the end, you got something, which was those points to then use at the store. Here on the on the Doodle side, you were hitting the tag everywhere to get all the collectibles. And at the end, you saw your collectible, but you unfortunately weren't able to, like, let's just say, even print it out or get one digital collectible.
I did hear
scavenger.
That's what the machines at the end were supposed to be doing is printing.
Exactly. So experience of the ribbon cutting event, unfortunately, that was what I personally thought was missing. But if you were telling me that later down the road, that is what it's for and what's going to happen, that's where I flipped the switch. I'm 110%. And instead of a 9.4, I'm a 10 out of 10 for what just happened. But it was a lot of fun. I had a great time. The whole experience for a kid is, it's literally, when I grew up, it was Wanadoo City or, again, Disney, Universal. Like, you go there, you experience it. On the Wanadoo City side, you experience jobs as a firefighter, as a police officer, as a baker. And then that's what you wanted to grow up to be. When you go to Disney, Mickey Mouse, you see the characters walking around. You go into the store, you want to buy Mickey Mouse. You want to buy Pluto. You want to buy a Marvel character. Same exact thing with your daughter there, where she saw Mello the cat. By the way, the main character of Doodles, we now officially know the name, which is Hap, and his companion, which is going to be Mello the cat. So again, your daughter saw the cat and was like, I want that stuffed animal, that plushie. So a lot of people, and by the way, your boy went semi-viral on X over the weekend from one of his videos of Doodles. And I, by the way, side note, I meant to go viral because I was fighting Futters all weekend long, and it turns out I'm actually a reply guy from what just went down on X. But it's just crazy to me that, and this kind of goes into like the next topic that we have, which is brand growth. And it's just crazy to me that the communities in the NFT space aren't seeing the opportunity that Doodle is doing with Camp, aren't seeing the opportunity what Pudgy is doing with their toys and plushies and everything on Amazon, going to Comic-Con. These communities aren't seeing how incredible of a job as well, like Cool Cats did in New York, as well as going to Comic-Con, also to brand growth, brand awareness. People don't understand. They're so caught up on what is this project going to bring back in value to me. And they're not focusing on, you understand, if the brand awareness grows and recognition grows and more stuffed animals, more plushies, more magnets, more everything gets in the hands of kids, as well as what you, all these people like to call Disney adults, aka your me, you're not going to grow a brand. You're not going to grow into something bigger. Look at Disney. Look at Universal Studios, look at Marvel, DC, Pokemon. All these people telling me on in my comments saying it's so stupid that they're it's so stupid that they're collabing with a kid's store. What kid's gonna buy a doodle for $2,000? And I'm like, let me give you an example. What happens when there's a Pokemon card that costs $10,000? Are you telling me that the kid can't play Pokemon because he can't buy the $10,000 card? No, you can still buy the $5, $6, $7, $8, $9, $10 booster pack, the $30 box, the $150 massive box, the plushies, the $60 Nintendo Switch game, and play Pokemon Go and spend money to get more Pokeballs. That
that's
are
just
$3,
for
four,
the
five,
ultimate nostalgia collector. That's not. That's a. There's a huge gap. There.
It's like telling me that the only way I can be a fan of Marvel is that if I buy the first ever comic that Stan Lee or just Marvel ever printed ever. And it's just beyond me that
the
just
necklace
that
Doctor Strange is wearing in the
exactly like the first one ever. That's the only way you can become a fan of these said brands and these IPs that what these NFT projects are trying to do. Again, what how I look at what we have invested in these profile pictures, not only, of course, your internet personality, but you're investing in what you believe is going to be the next massive IP. And when you look at Doodles and me personally, when I look at Cool Cats or when you look at Pudgy Penguins, that's what we see. And it's just crazy to me that just these people don't see that. And by the way, it's either a M'lady or a M'lady derivative. Those are the biggest fudders in the space right now. God damn, you guys are so negative and weird. And a lot of weird crypto, like crypto centric people as well. Like they were just in the comments. I was like, holy crap, let me go fight them. I'm listen, Cryer. If there's one thing that came out of this weekend is that I've figured out I am definitely a reply guy, and I meant to go semi-viral. Like a few, like once or twice.
Get some more of those going.
Yeah, I got to. It was just going crazy. But Cry, what's your take? I talked a lot there. So what do you think? Are you in agreement with me? Are you not? What do you think?
No, I definitely agree. We've seen a lot of the companies that have just been it's NFT capitulation event. You know, 100%. It's been we're at max pain. Yuga's falling off a cliff. Everything's dying. Everything's dead. But realistically, if the project is funded and they're still doing stuff and they're still delivering things that are enjoyable, they're trying to make new revenue streams, revenue models. Like me personally, looking like at this versus D-Gods, do I want a new color scheme for my picture or do I want a working product, like an experience product that kids can latch onto and grow a business? Or it doesn't make any sense. 100%. And again, so another example is my mother-in-law came with us. She got to go on Saturday with us. She's 70. She was like, wow, this is really fun. This is all the stuff. When you guys leave and leave me with the kids, this is what you're going to do. This is great. I love this stuff. She's like, I want to buy a doodle. She said she wants to buy a doodle, like a real one.
There you
and
have
I'm
it.
Like, and I told her, I was like, it's like a couple $1,000s. She's like, yeah, but like you get access to all this stuff or whatever. And it's I already have access to it, like through the thing. But she was just like, I just want to fit in with. I feel like that was fun. She doesn't have anything to do with any of this stuff, or doesn't know anything about it. And she had a great weekend because she got to experience a lot of the. So not only were we did the event, that was the event. We also had a bunch of community events that were handled incredibly well. Before the event, they chose the incubator, which is like the Doodle DAO rename. They have a new council members. Everyone's focused on delivering things to the community. There's been mostly like community meetup types things. You can propose businesses if they get it approved. Could be related to this. You make merchandise or something like that. There's a lot of opportunities there on that side too. So not only are we delivering experiences there, what I was always mad about was they never did anything with the Doodle DAO. And now they've corrected that pretty well. Like in the last, you know, couple months, they've actually listened and been like, yeah, we've neglected that part of this entire thing this entire time. So let's get some excited community members in charge of it and let's focus on it. They had three winners for the grant that was for this, that was up to pretty much like 10 grand in value to be distributed between three people based on their proposals for what they would do for the event, right? They did Jenny from the blockchain. She made a couple of videos. The best one by far was Burry, right? So Michael Burry, who's from Chicago, and his proposal was to plan events for Doodles members to go for free to do, right? So I got to go on a yacht for a lake cruise while the air show was going on for flyovers, stuff like that. I got a free buffet and kids are going crazy. They haven't been on a boat like this before. They loved it. Dancing all over the place. We get to hang out with 30 or 40 doodles. Have a good time. That's the kind of the essence of all this stuff. Again, if you have you get access to a lot of these things. And he also did like a swing and sip golf, like a simulator golf sim thing, like free food, free drinks. And it's multiple times. So you had like three, and then you got the Wrigley Field game. You got to experience a lot of Chicago. You went to this event. I paid like $1,000 for an Airbnb for the whole family. Got to do all this. Got to go big, had fun at the doodle event. And then I got to do a lot of just like touristy things. I had been to Chicago with the family and it was all like free practically because all the things that we did were included. That's a pretty big win, I think, for the ecosystem on there. And now they're having spaces talking about the incubator of what they can provide. And I really want people to start focusing on propose anything. And if it is something that's viable and people want to see it, then it's going to get traction now, right? Because the previous time you just made a proposal, no one was in charge of anything. No one voted. They all failed unless it was like heavily pushed and marketed. So shout out to like people like Tony P, and they're getting a lot of word out about the voting and stuff like that. But we haven't seen a lot of stuff that came out. I would say the biggest thing was the Wizard DAO thing with the tournament, but that's all getting set up or whatever. I just think that there's a lot of future opportunity, especially if you're going the route of the IP and building with your stuff and having a company, and you can be funded by the Doodle Bank if it's a good proposal, helps you set up a business. I think that's a huge move.
No, I definitely agree. And it goes all the way back to, again, all these projects, just this brand growth and brand awareness. Sure. This is what is needed. And then on the side of community, this is what we've all been asking for. Literally what you just said, like when we go to these set events, if it's South by Southwest, if it's NFT NYC, if it's Art Basel, if it's this event at camp, like you, not only do you want the event, but these community-led events also provide an opportunity for you to experience the community, number one, and number two, to showcase this community so more people want to be a part of it. The great thing about all of this was these community-led events as well, and also this camp ribbon cutting event, you were able to bring a plus one. So we always make fun of those events, which I always make fun of. It was Adidas in Miami where they had no plus ones, but like a plus one is such an incredible opportunity for you to showcase what this is all about. If it's your significant other, if it's a friend, if it's a family member, if it's a random person on the internet, pretty much what we just did over the weekend with ZZ, like he literally just slid in with us. He didn't have a doodle. We showed him the whole thing. By the way, we showed him the NRN way, which is not any other way than any other person or group can do. So that was a little bit of he got an upgraded stay with the whole doodle event, but that's besides the point. But at the end of it, he was like, this was incredible. And from all the conversations I've had with him and prior to this, he's always been like making fun of doodles and saying shit about them. And to see that like completely 360s, holy shit, this is what
I guarantee you. If any of these people in the space that have seen doodles and do stuff, and we just brought them there for free, or there's no way they wouldn't be like, this is pretty cool. There's no way.
Unless they literally hate fun. Yeah. It should be pretty, or unless like you're Beanie or something like that you just have to find something negative to say about it. Or me, I typically find something negative. Yeah,
It's just they're all like those with the actual doodles people, all the colorless doodles walking around.
Yeah, literally. But listen, from the activation standpoint, it was pretty cool how they just put everything together. And a lot of people are missing the fact that on the backside, I know it's just little mini games, but Doodles turned into a little mini game video game company. And on the backside, if you went to the back of the camp store, all the way in the back, there's I think 5 or 6 Doodle mini games that we've never seen before. Obviously it's like Flappy Bird and like games that we know of, but it's incorporated with Doodle's characters. And listen, those games, you slap them on something like Gamey, which we experience with Cool Cats, or even just on the Apple Store and the Google Store, just let it out there, people are literally addicted to addicting games. So that could be something that they should look into a little bit more. But other than that, again, just the experience overall was unbelievable. Chicago, a 10 out of 10 compared to New York. Shout out for sure.
More events in Chicago for sure. Absolutely. Cheaper, way cleaner, 100%. Way nicer, way more fun. A lot of stuff to do.
I just hate New York. And the Yankees, by the way, they're on like the
New York feels like double years, price of everything.
Everything. Oh yeah. But shout out on my end to Yaba for allowing me to stay. Very good host. We had a blast. We had a good amount of the NRN group from FUD, Annabelle, Nate, Cryer, Mrs. Cryer, Yaba. Who else did we have over there? Sob was out there. Shout out to Mushy. I actually had, oh my Lord, Cryer, I had 6 or 7 shots with Mushy.
Yeah, I remember.
Burnt Toast and the CEO, Julian. And they had no idea with what a green tea shot was. And the second they tasted, they're like, this isn't alcohol. Let's have 6 more. I'm like, I'm just sitting there. Like, sure. Just kept going and going. But again, it was just a blast just to being with the team. And by the way, shout out to Doodles for having that after party event. It was all you can eat, all you can drink for all the Doodle holders. And to be honest, if you just walked in there, you probably could have got a drink or some food. If you're there, everyone was already having a blast. But yeah, Chicago was a blast. They need to do more of these events. We're winding down into what are we looking in the near future? It's on my end, the Macy's Thanksgiving parade for Cool Cats. Unfortunately, I don't think I'm going to be able to go, but after that, the big one is obviously Art Basel. So hopefully we can start seeing some of these projects saying if they're going or not at a reasonable time so that their holders can start booking what they need to and making sure that they're able to go. And by the way, did a reasonable time, not a few days before, so we can make our plans. Thank you so much. All right, let's jump into some nerd stuff, Cryer, because the greatest character of all time in Star Wars history just had her show release on Disney Plus. 2 episodes of Ahsoka Tano have released on Disney Plus. By the way, they actually listened to the community and they put it into the time slot of Game of Thrones or The Last of Us. They put it at 9 p.m., not at 12 at night, midnight, so people woke up at 3 a.m. on Eastern side just to watch the show. They put it at a good time so people can watch it with their friends and family, their significant other, their kids. And Cryer, this felt like a season 5 of Rebels, which is probably hands down one of the best Star Wars shows I've seen. At least not, the first few episodes weren't that good, but after the first season, what an incredible show. Ahsoka's out. Nothing but good things I saw from it. Ahsoka is literally my favorite character of all time. She is a Jedi, by the way, for all those Star Wars nerds that went off on me. I want an apology letter from all of you. I literally went semi-viral like a few months ago saying how she isn't a Jedi, which I get it, but she's a Jedi. But Cryer, did you happen to get a chance to at least watch one episode?
I have not. I'll get around to it. It looks good, though.
All right. Sure. We need some homework. It's fine. Listen, Cryer is not a big fan of Mandalorian. The reason for that is because there's no lightsabers. And let me tell you, Cryer.
No forces. No force powers.
No force. On this one, there is force. A bunch of lightsabers and a lot of fights. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Hopefully they do a good job here. But other than that, Cryer, on the video game side, on my side, I've just been focusing on Marvel Snap, by the way, just released you're actually officially able to play Marvel Snap on PC. It's not in beta mode anymore on Steam, and it looks phenomenal. They updated the UI completely, and it looks like badass. Everything looks super nice. The cards even look better. And on top of that, they released like a little mini, like 2 minute or actually like minute and 30 second video, just like the introduction to Marvel Snap. And they had like Ghost Rider fighting Deadpool, fighting Squirrel Girl, going against Devil Dinosaur, and all of Marvel fandom is going crazy saying the graphics and the little mini clip is phenomenal and they wish they had a show just like it. So Marvel Snap is doing just incredible things on that side. And of course, right now on Twitch, they're doing like a Twitch massive raid of Marvel Snap for the next week. And if you watch up to 8 hours, so ever, or excuse me, 2 hours, 4 hours, and I think 6 or 8 hours, it's 3 of Marvel Snap on Twitch. Just put it on the background of your phone or your computer, and you're going to receive a bunch of variants and credits and titles and a bunch of stuff in game for absolutely free, just putting it on Twitch. And it's been going good, man. This is actually pretty crazy how Marvel Snap started really well. It died out a little bit, and from the last 2 days, there's like literally hundreds of thousands of people on Twitch right now watching, obviously because they want the variants. But from the content creators that I've been talking to and going in their streams and watching, like, they're pumped and it's getting really good. So hopefully Marvel Snap can go on that side. But obviously, let's turn it over to you on the Web3 side, because you've still been playing this. I always forget the game that you're playing right now. What is it called?
Dark and Darker?
Yes.
That's not Web3. It's just
like, it's not Web3. I was jabronied. Oh my lord. So you're just playing a random game that's scary as hell and you're trying to make me play?
It's not scary at all. What are you talking about, scary?
Oh, it's not? Oh, no. Never mind then. So you're just playing,
it's just like an RPG game where you're like dungeon crawling and you're fighting people.
Oh, okay.
So you'll be like, I'm a bard, so I have like instruments and I play songs that buff me up. And then there's 18 people that get dropped into a dungeon and there's only 6 exits. And you have to collect the gear and then exit the game. But you kill other people to get their stuff. And if you die in the game, then you don't get to keep any of the things you found. And it's okay. Repetitive.
Oh, we talked. Like, yeah, we definitely talked
like about Battle Royale a little bit.
Yeah.
But super fun. They did such a great job on balancing of the skills and very just each class feels like crazy unique, which I think is really strong in an RPG game because it has a lot of replay factor for that, because then you can play it with the other characters. So now you have nine characters you can play at the game with.
Okay.
Yeah,
and it was like
cheap, $30 or something.
Okay. And is it on Steam or Xbox, PlayStation? Where can you?
It is. They have their own, but it's just, it like just came out. It's like an early access game. Okay. They're getting added to Steam, and then it is their website was like Discord Darker. They have their own launcher and everything.
Okay, that's pretty cool. And then also on, let's actually jump over to the Web3 side. Parallel, have you still been playing? Yeah. I've actually been.
We were in Chicago, obviously.
Yeah.
Dude, it's incredible. You should definitely.
Yeah, a lot of people are telling me to play it. A lot of people are talking about it. I definitely have to jump on and play around with the game. But this is something, again, things are moving, man. Again, the space is going in the direction that we've all been asking for, from Doodles in Camp to Cool Cats and Pudgy at Comic-Con to even Gary V. I know you don't like Gary V, but V Friends and the Reebok shoes that are coming out. At the end of the day, this is how these brands are going to build and going to grow within the space and outside of the space. And that's literally what we need. Again, shout out to those builders, shout out to those founders and team members that are just crushing it day in and day out. And jump on the podcast while you're at it so that we can talk a little bit more the ins and outs of what's going on behind the scenes of Web3.
Yeah, we should have a couple of good guests. I think we got Julian. He said he'd jump on with us from Doodles.
See, this is the difference between me and Cryer. Cryer goes to Doodles in Chicago.
Yeah, actually,
does work and then talks to Julian, and goes, hey, you should jump on the podcast. And then on the flip side, RSG, myself, I'm just take bulldozing shots with the dude instead. So here's to Cryer for being him and only him, and no one else can be him. So there's to that. But other than that, again, the space is growing. The space is moving.
I got one little comment to talk about here while the way out. On Parallel, there was a guy who was like, he has an account that straight up just only bashes NFTs. Like, I think his name's like keep NFTs out of games or out of my games or something like that. And
okay.
He's on the top leaderboard for Parallels. Not like in the top, but like he was on the leaderboard. So he's playing it. Someone like found it through the account or whatever, and was posted about it. And I just thought it was hilarious because you don't know that it's there at all. Like, literally, you can't even, you don't know at all. You just make an account, play the game, and it's good. I definitely think we should jump on. Let's do it.
No, I would love to. I definitely have to, and hopefully can find the time to go ahead and do that. But again, we're happy. We're happy things are doing. Obviously, prices are down, but you got to keep your head down. You got to keep buying the dip. Actually, you probably shouldn't buy the dip if you don't have the money. But if you do have the money, buy the dip. Get into those favorite projects
I was
that
looking
you
at Bored
enjoy
Apes
and love. Wow.
couple of days.
Oh man. See, this is what happens when you make a shit ton of money in shit coins. You start looking at Bored Apes. So Crier, shout out to you. Hopefully we can have an honorary ape over here that actually knows what's going on in Yuga. Shout out to Nate Physical,
Yeah.
aka Nate Digital, aka
Coffee boy.
just Coffee Boy. But things are moving. Listen, if Crier's looking at apes and we're flying to Chicago for NFT events and we're going into Art Basel very soon, that means things are moving. And
Well,
the
don't.
last thing, yeah, the la I was literally going to say, the last thing I'd like to say is whenever you hear us say we're
Go
going
to an
to an
event.
NFT event,
Short the market.
short the fuck out of anything. It doesn't have to even be NFTs, just short
Yeah,
rice,
short
short
Bitcoin.
salt, short metals, short corn. You're going to make money off us going to events. Keep grabbing those bricks.
Up signal.
Keep coming back to our podcast, and we'll catch you guys later for another episode of Nerd FT Radio. Peace.
Peace.
Damn.